Farm Digest with Chet Randolph.
Hello, I'm Chet Randolph. Welcome to the first edition of Farm Digest. There's an old saying that the only things certain in life are death and taxes. Well, in election year, that's not always the case.
This is what the farmer put in, the heel in one slice. This is what somebody else put in that loaf of bread. It cost more in this town this morning to deliver that loaf of bread from the bakery door to the supermarket shelf than it cost to put the wheat in it.
And remember, the first week in January, we'll start the new year with a new name, Market to Market. Until then, I'm Chet Randolph. Thanks for joining us and have a good holiday.
The 17 million tons of grain ordered by the Soviet Union, in excess of that amount which we are committed to sell, will not be delivered. I am determined to minimize any adverse impact on the American farmer from this action.
Our grain exports this year will exceed last year's business by 10 million tons without the Russians. We don't need them. They're more trouble than they're worth.
We are prepared to announce a massive acreage reduction program. And I think, as most of you are aware, setting land aside is not my cup of tea. One must understand the nature of American farmers to fully realize the significance of these figures.
No sale! No way! No sale! No sale! No way! No sale! No way!
You know, George Washington said that agriculture was our most important industry. Thomas Jefferson said that our tillers of the soil were our most important citizens and the backbone of our whole democratic republic. And then David Stockman comes along and says, unlike Washington and Jefferson and Lincoln, farm bankruptcies are needed. Forget David Stockman.
I thought one day maybe I'd get rich and have my own farm, and then I'd have people working for me. And finally that happened, and last year I lost $800,000 feeding cattle.
And there stood Leon on his land with a shotgun in his hand. His eyes were narrowed beneath the brim of his hat. He said, I've worked hard on this land as a boy and as a man, and I'll lose it now to no damn bureaucrat.
We call on the governor, we call on Governor Branstad and the legislature to declare to Congress that the 85 Farm Bill is totally inadequate.
Governor, upon how well you listen to our people and respond will decide on how whether people are going to live or die.
Now all of a sudden we've got Silicon Valley in agriculture. We've got a big change.
And to have more government, I think, is like throwing a drowning man another bucket of water. That isn't what you need. We simply need to get to higher net farm income through the market system and get our checks from what we sell, not from the government.
Hello, I'm Mark Pearson. The Federal Reserve this week reported signs of life in the U.S. economy.
Bringing in more corporate capital is going to mean a very changed nature of rural communities. It's going to start meaning that the primary returns to agriculture, which had traditionally been in land ownership, start flowing away from the people that work on the farm.